In this video, we will see how to create a space combat game. So basically, this game is related to space, and I have beautifully decorated this app to attract the users towards this game. So you can see I have added three beautiful buttons here. When I click on play button, here comes a loading screen. So you can see the speed is so fast, and quickly it redirects me to the play area. Here I'll tell you how to play this game. So basically, this is a fighter plane and this is a UFO. You have to hit the UFO using the fight, means fireballs are shot from the fighter plane. You have to move your fighter plane left and right in order to shoot the UFO. Once the UFO is hit by the fireball, automatically your score is increased by 1. And once you clear each level, the speed of the UFO keeps on increasing to make the game even more challenging. And once you can see the UFO reaches the edge, the game is over. And you can see that my score is 20. And I have got a screen here that is game over, and I can restart my game. So if I click on restart, my score is set to 0 and I can play the game again. If I press the back button, it redirects me to the home screen. Now if I go to the statistics button, here you can see that it records my last game score. So whatever was the score in my last game, it will record that and it will save it here. So since I had played another game in this video, so you could see that the score 3 is saved. So next time if you close your app and if you open it again, you will get an idea what your score was last time. So you can beat that score. Fine. And here you can see one rules button. Whenever the rules button is clicked, you can add certain rules here, like which button is to be clicked to move the airplane, and what are the rules which you have set. So you can just add those rules here according to your needs, according to the game which we have developed.
So I would like to just tell you that for this game, there are going to be 3 videos. Because this game is very lengthy, it is going to have 3 parts. In the first part, I am going to show you how to design all the screens. In the second part, I will show you how to code for the first 2 screens. And in the third video, we will see how to program the final game area. So, I am going to start my new project and I will give it a name as Space Combat Game. Okay. So, now we are going to design the screen first. So screen 1 title, I will change it to the name of our game, that is Space Combat. Now I am going to add 3 buttons here along with the labeling button to create some gap. And one label at the top. So I have taken 4 labels and 3 buttons. Now remove the text from label 1. Remove the text from label 2 and 3 as well. Now go to screen 1 and align horizontally center, align vertically center. Now change the text for the label 4 to size as 28. Pick background color as black and text color should be height 5. Now we are going to upload some assets to make our game look more beautiful. So I'll upload few assets here. So first I'll upload the space background and I will upload the images of 3 buttons. So I have uploaded all the assets which is required for this screen. Now I will just remove the text from button 1 and I will change the image to play button, not PNG. Now change the height to 18% and change the width to 70%. Now change this button, remove the text, set image to use button and make the height as 18% and width as 70%. Similarly, do it with the third button. Now I will just change the background image to space background. So the design of our first screen is completed. And I am going to add one more component. I'll go to media and I will add player in order to add a sound to this screen. Now I will add one screen and that is going to be our splash screen, that is the loading screen. So I have added one new screen. Now I will design the screen. So first of all I will add an image here and I will just upload one image here, fighter playing game to image. So the image is uploaded. Now I will change image 1 picture to fighter playing game.png and I will change the height to 50% and width as per value and scale picture to fit option, you enable it. Now just make the height to something 65% you make it. And now go to the main screen, that is splash screen, and here align horizontally center and you can see screen orientation. Just click on this drop down and select portrait. Now add one more label here, remove the text from the label, add one more label, two more labels to add and add one slider component and make this look as fill band or just make the slider width as 90% or you make it something like 5%. For this you remove the text. Here you just write loading and add some dots. Here we remove the text from label 3. Now here label 2 you make phone hold. Background color should be black. Text color should be white. make the font size something 20, or just make it 25, and change the background image to space background. So we have designed this screen as well. Now moving forward to our last screen, that is going to be our main play area. So our playing arena, we are going to design it. I'll give it a name as play. So first of all here, I'll change the background image to fighter playing game. No, I'll just change the background image to space background. Just here you can see an option title visible. So just disable that option. And just make the screen orientation portrait. Now go to layout and add one horizontal arrangement, add one vertical arrangement, and at last go to drawing and animation and add one canvas. Horizontal arrangement you make with aspect parent, and here you add one label and one new label. So in the first label you just take that text here as core and colon, and I will just add some space here in the text, and in the second text I'll just add 0. Now go to horizontal arrangement and align everything in the center. Just change the size to 20 for bold. And similarly for the text label. Change the label to text. Rename it as school label. Here, just add one label. Vertical arrangement you make with as fill parent. Width as fill parent and height as fill parent. Now align everything in the center. Make the text as game over. So whenever our game is over, we will make this screen visible. And just add one exclamation mark. Now add one more label and add one button. Remove the text from label 3. Change this font size to 28. Font bold. Background color should be black and text color should be white. Go to vertical arrangement and just add background color to none. Now change this button background color to custom and make it white. And just add text here. Make the font size 20, font bold, shape should be rounded, and add text that is restart. Now just make this button 1, rename this button 1 as restart underscore and just make this vertical arrangement 1 non-visible. Now for this canvas you make height as fill parent, width as fill parent and just make this also non-visible for some time and add one. Go to layout and add one horizontal arrangement. Take with as fill parent. Go to user interface and drag two buttons and drag one label in between. Remove the text from label. Change button one text to left and change this text to right. Align horizontal center, align vertically center. And now I will just design the buttons. Now I'll just make this canvas to visible and just place canvas above the horizontal arrangement. Okay, just remove the canvas and here I'll just place it. Yeah. Here I'll place it. So in our next video, we will see how to add the components in the canvas and how to code for our screens. So bye for this video. I hope you liked it, and if you have any doubts, ask me on comment. And for the assets, you can visit the description box. Thank you.